A political contest between youthful Kipchumba Murkomen and former powerful politician Nicholas Biwott is easily a perfect billing of a David versus Goliath encounter.
I want to unite the two communities. I want to show them different leadership. I want to put in place leadership that has integrity, that has values-based, that people can be able to be trusted for what they say. Very sadly, those who are, some of them competing with me, people who played a role in previous regimes, actually played against the people by amassing so much wealth at the expense of the people.
Such is the political metrics of the race for Senator of Elgeyo Marakwet County. But the difference of their worlds notwithstanding, the soil is ripe for this battle of not equals. But Murkomen, a lecturer of law and a constitutional expert, is undeterred in his bid as he believes his background as a lawyer gives him sufficient experience in political understanding and public affairs and is therefore not disadvantaged by the age-old seasoning of his rival. Former powerful cabinet minister Nicholas Biwott has a head start in the race for Senate for Elgeyo Marakwet County, but the tilt of the youth vote cannot be ignored, a fact that gives the youthful Kipchumba Murkomen some hope of shaping matters in the political scene of this particular county. The race for governor is not any different except for the fact that it has attracted rivals with a corporate background. Abraham Talel and David Kimosop are the main contenders, and this can be described as a battle of equal, since they are both new in the political pool, which makes the race a wide open affair, at least for now.
I know Abraham is one person who is a diligent leader in terms of giving us good vision in that county. I know him as one person who has a deep experience.
I'm a student of good corporate governance. So issues of misuse of resources, mismanagement will be history in Elgeyo Marakwet County. So we'll make sure we have structures to create efficiency and proper utilization of resources within the county.
With interpretation of the real issues well articulated by majority of those gunning for positions, the political tiebreaker may be how the opponents unleash their trump cards in the sense of which constituency of voters they will attract the most and how they would then dangle that carrot as bait for other categories of voters.
Then you have to accomplish to your task the way you promised. And then another thing, this leader sometimes they are just, they can say something and whenever they have succeeded, they disappear. That is our worry.
National politics does not seem to have a bearing on how the people here will choose their grassroots leaders. But the one sure thing is that Elgeyo Marakwet County will not alienate itself from how their neighbors will vote for as the country's chief executive, which diminishes the possibility of the famous three-piece ballot marking, which is this time round much more expanded.
Look, for example, just let's go to the latest one, 207. Yeah? I was voted in as Kenda. Majority of their voters gave me for MP. But for president, they gave to Raila. In 202, when everybody else was Kano, they gave me a NAC.
As a community, we'd want to move and ensure that we go to a party that we know will form the next government. As to what that party is today, we still people are in discussions. This area and North Rift in general are looking at UDM. And basically then we'll be having people who will be going to all other parties, but as a block, it will be much better to have a scenario where you're moving as a block.
Others with a shout at the county leadership in 2012 include 32-year-old accountant Albert Kochei eyeing the governor's position. The main challenge is how the county would rise above the cultural orientation of its society to attain the one-third gender balance, as women are considered naive in offering themselves for leadership positions.
So tunashindwa vile wamama watafanya sababu wenyewe wanashindwa kuomba fiketi. Hata kwa baraza ukiambia mama tupee chenda moja aongee inakuwa shida. So at least labda maji biwa hata mama mheshimiwa Lina Kilimo atasaidia wale wamama wengine. Sababu unaona sasa yeye ndio sasa anaweza elewa na kuambia wamama waamke vizuri.
But that aside, the main challenge remains how Elgeyo Marakwet County will use its share of the 15% of the national budget in transforming this county and build infrastructure and, among other things, make Rio Valley productive in a bid to spur socio-economic growth. Milton Nyakundi for Channel 1 County Power Metrics at the E10 Viewpoint.